Mic test. My mic up a little bit more. Mic test. All right, there we go. This bathroom trip. Oh, to do anything. Something a lot. That was just a waste of time.
How's Medissa been acting?
She's calm. It looks like letting her in on the truth worked as well as we thought it might.
Good. Maybe she'll be easier to control now.
Oh, you're gonna kill him?
Halt! Who are you?
For the Ghostbusters. That's stupid.
Yeah.
Man, come on. Damn, dude, I can't even get anything started. Wait, I can't even... Wait, did they? No, I don't want to switch characters. It did something wrong. I didn't want to do that. I don't even know I did that. There we go.
Heading out.
I'm not waiting.
Understood. Let's do our best.
This is stupid. Ah, before we do anything. Thank you.
Show him
how. Oh, Medissa really is here.
But what's this about the truth and controlling her?
What kind of doll is this? Chocolate. Wow, okay. Never occurred to me those things actually have different looks. There we go. Thank you. Let's hide. Put somebody else in this. Back door, okay.
Barrier. She's a Therian.
Third time's the charm, eh, kid?
Yeah.
I don't know how come you're gonna put that all off his neck.
You're Medissa?
I am. And who might you be?
We're the Power Rangers.
We're like you. We carry grudges against the Abbey. And Shepherd Artorias.
It's gonna be okay. We came to get you out of here, Medissa.
There's no escape.
What? Please, don't give up. I can...
No, you don't understand. There's no escape for you. If you dare sully Shepherd Artorias' ideals and the light the Abbey shines upon the world, I will kill you all!
Why are you?
That is you.
Are you doing this?
She's the Abbey's Yaki now. Way to jinx it, Rokuro.
Just keep coming.
That snake woman keeps summoning them. If we don't go after her directly, there'll be no end to it.
Your left hand. Don't tell me you're the Calamity.
Why are you doing this, Medissa? Why fight for the Abbey after they forced you to become a Therian?
They didn't. I became one of my own free will.
But your daughter, slain at an exorcist's hands! You must hate the Abbey for that, don't you?
Oh, I feel hate. Toward a world where demons spawn from the people's malevolence!
You know about malevolence?
The exorcist told me the truth. Diana turned into a demon because of the malevolence she radiated. I knew what I had to do. Become a Therian, and devour malevolence so that such a tragedy would never repeat itself. It matters not what dreadful form my body will take. I will revive Innominaut and change this wretched world! If that's how it is, fine. We'll take you by force.
for wind and earth. Wind and earth, probably get rid of that. Get rid of that. That back on. That back on. You know what? That's the hurrah. Follow dance would be better. If I ever seen it.
It's over. Curse you, Lord of Calamity.
Lord of Calamity?
That's the name of the demon lord who will bring about the Age of Chaos. The unrepentant embodiment of malevolence, whose blind pursuit of self-gratification will rain destruction upon the world. The irredeemable, uncontrollable personification of human sins.
an evil like you.
Demon, Therian, Lord of Calamity, call me whatever you like. But if I'm the supposed Lord of Demons, then you're just a minion to be used as I please, nothing more.
No, I refuse. What happened to my Diana was my fault. That's why I will fight you until my dying breath!
Stop!
Don't get in my way!
No! Enough mothers have died. I won't let you join them! Eleanor and Kamawana, they both lost their mothers too. It's a terrible thing.
Kamawana?
A little girl that the Abbey forcefully made into a Therian. Her mother tried to save her, but she failed. All she could do was to offer her own life to fill her child's empty stomach. Kamawana's been crying ever since. She misses her mother. If you die here, I can only imagine how sad that would make your Diana.
Diana!
You don't need me anymore, Mom. I get it. You love this new dad more than your own daughter!
No, honey. I did it for you.
But you really thought I stopped loving you. And the malevolence made you into a demon. It's all my fault. I'm so sorry. Forgive me, Diana.
Medissa.
She'll be all right. She's just unconscious.
Let's grab her and haul her back.
I'll place her under a binding arc, just in case.
Gotta hand it to the Abbey. Very resourceful, taking advantage of Medissa's regrets like that. Making her into a Therian who would do their bidding.
It's just so cruel.
Who cares? Reason above all, no?
It's true. The way I feel goes, there's no telling what'll happen to Helaphys once we take Medissa out of here. And yet I'm doing exactly that, all on account of my own hang-ups. Even crushing Medissa's honest resolve.
According to reason, malevolence is the fault of the individual. You assume no responsibility or guilt for what happens to them.
I refuse to turn a blind eye to the consequences of my actions. I chose this path to seek the truth, not to deny it. If I'm to betray reason, then that is the very least I should do.
You're too much, you know that? You and Medissa both. Quit overthinking things. Just blame all the suffering on the Lord of Calamity. Makes life easier.
Velvet,
I'm not trying to cheer you up. I'm just saying it doesn't bother me. Whatever's coming, I can handle it.
I was wondering, do you think I hurt Medissa saying that stuff to her back there?
Yeah, pretty much.
I suppose you might have. But I was thinking the exact same things you were. Losing a mother. It's always a tragedy. I'm glad you stepped in and stopped her.
Thanks.
That Eleanor, I swear, she feels way more responsibility for everything than she needs to.
You think we need to worry? What if she pushes too far and erupts with malevolence?
Malevolence is born out of many things. A prideful ego. The self-righteousness that turns a blind eye to one's inner contradictions. Eleanor is different. She's mindful of her ego and strives to confront her inconsistencies of character.
She has a purity of heart that won't be tainted by the emotions that create malevolence. No other quality is as essential for an exorcist.
So she's probably okay?
For now, at least. But human hearts can be fickle things. Who knows what the future holds?
I doubt you got anything to worry about. For most exorcists, purity is a construct of the Abbey's teachings. But Eleanor, she's the real deal.
She's not your average exorcist, I'll give you that.
Purity is handy for any exorcist. But more than that, it's a rare and precious temperament for living. Everybody's got an ego and certain internal contradictions to some degree. Facing one's own ugliness in an honest manner is never easy. To be a normal human is to live carrying malevolence. It's just how much you let it control you that varies.
I guess malevolence might just be a fact of life, huh? But Artorias can't accept that.
Well, I don't see anything out of the ordinary.
Let's slip through town and head for Titania before that changes.
So this is your secret hideout. Once I get free, he won't stand a chance. You all had better sleep with one eye open.
Look how worried I am.
Welcome back!
That's Kamoana.
She's the same age as Diana. Did the Abbey really turn someone so young into a Therian?
Really? I really don't want to see that.
Eleanor!
Mendissa, please, would you be able to talk to her?
Is this a trick?
Kamoana may be a Therian, but deep down, she's still a normal little girl who misses her mother. I can't do anything to console her. No matter what I try, but if it were you...
You okay? You can call me Medissa, all right? Do I scare you, honey?
A little. But not as much as Velvet and Dial. But don't you think I'm scary? I had a bad dream earlier. My mommy said I looked scary and that she didn't want me anymore.
She would never. Your mother would never think that about her daughter.
But how do you know?
Because I'm a mother too. Mothers always love their children, no matter what. No matter if we die. No matter how the world changes. There's nobody who loves you more in the world than...
It's okay. You don't have to cry.
I hope Kamawana and Odessa
won't have to feel so lonely anymore.
Yeah, trying to stop the waterworks gets old fast.
Listen, if it's not too personal, was your mother,
She's dead. I lost her when I was even younger than you.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
It's fine. It just means we've got things in common. So no feeling sad and alone, okay?
Oh no, I'm fine. I don't feel lonely or anything, I swear.
What's gotten into you? You're so strange sometimes.
No, I'm not.
Eleanor, I'll have you watch over Kamawana and Medissa.
Yes, of course. I'd be honored. Thank you.
Are exorcists supposed to be so polite to a grand poobah of calamity or whatever?
Sure, why not? Besides, the Demonlord ought to not trouble herself over such trivialities.
Velvet, Grimoire's calling for you. She says to bring Lafayette and meet her at the observation tower.
Got it.
We better get going.
We're going to the observation tower. I think we need to take this way. Hope I'm right, because this place can get confusing. At least I get some cats on the way.
Mothers?
Where'd that question come from?
Well, after hearing that Velvet, Kamawana, and Eleanor all lost their parents, I just got curious.
My mother was a strict, frightening woman, but she died a long time ago.
I see.
I have no parents either, but the wicked witch who took me in said I was born from a peach that floated down the river.
Coming from you, I'd almost believe that.
And you, Aizen?
We Malakim are formed from untainted mana. Sometimes humans are reborn as Malakim, but they retain no memory of their previous lives. In other words, we don't have blood relations like humans do.
I see. By the time I was aware of anything around me, I was already tethered and being called number two. I suppose having no mother means I don't have any memories before that. I told Medissa that losing a mother is painful, but I can't know how painful it is.
Go easy on him, Aizen. He's just a kid.
I'm just telling it like it is. But listen to me, Lafayette. You can share deep connections with other people, even if you don't have a biological family. Malakim, too, can form precious bonds, true friendships, even family.
That's right. Your words wouldn't have stopped Medissa if they weren't true in your heart.
You really think so?
I'm sure of it.
It's far better than being a witch born from a peach.
Nonsense! There's no nobler way to be born! I have an everlasting friendship with a dog, a monkey, a pheasant, and Bienfu.
I hope he's right.
Right. Backtrack. North Watchtower. Okay.
You said that Malakim can have familial ties, but what makes you and your sister siblings if you're not related by blood?
Well, a very long time ago, I was born into this world from an Earth Pulse point up on a sacred mountain. I remained in that place for a long while, and then one day, she was born from the very same Earth Pulse point. Before we knew it, we had wound up living together under the same roof.
Are two Malakim always siblings if they come from the same Earth Pulse point?
No. The other Malakim were born there, but I never felt like they were my family. But something, I don't know what, was different with her. If she was sad, I'd feel sad. And if I was happy, she'd be happy too. She can be abrasive, but when she smiles, it's like nothing else. I swore to myself that whatever happened, I would protect her. I made a pendant from a stone on that sacred mountain and gave it to her as a lucky charm. Of course, she just wears it as a necklace.
And your pendant? Did she give that to you?
She had the same idea I had. She made the pendant herself and gave it to me as a good luck charm. Without either of us having mentioned a word of it beforehand, we each gave each other pendants in the same shape on the very same day. That's when I really knew that what I had felt all along was true. We were brother and sister.
Is that her in the picture?
Yeah. It's a self-portrait she drew for me on the day I left home.
Did you draw her a picture of yourself?
No. I don't exactly have an artistic side.
Well, I'm sure that if you looked inside her pendant, you'd find a portrait of the person who matters most to her.
I hope so.
Yeah, and it would be nice if it was you.
Ah, there you two are.
Hi, teacher. Have you made progress deciphering the book?
I have indeed. It turns out there was a second counting song. I've already transcribed it. Would you read it aloud for us, child?
Okay. When the eight malevolences overflow, in the culmination of mankind's despair, Ennomenot will bring an end to all peoples and restore them to time immemorial. Four Empyreans shall wield a wrathful sword and cleave the great devourer, two asunder to sleep beneath the earth, as scarlet moonlight illuminates the evil. The nameless Empyrean hath one heart. The nameless Empyrean hath one body.
Oh, yet more delightful material to keep us awake at night.
If I'm understanding this right, it's discussing the specific nature of Ennomenot? That's what I believe, yes. When the eight malevolences overflow in the culmination of mankind's despair, Ennomenot will bring an end to all peoples.
So, when the world is at peak malevolence, Ennomenot will use that power to bring an end to all. Is that it?
He's going to wipe out all of humanity?
Is that what the Abbey is after? Is that why they've been trying to bring back Ennomenot?
No. Artorias is not that kind of man. His two primary ideals are the many over one, and the restoration of order through will and reason. He sacrificed Lofi to protect this world, not to eradicate it.
You mean that's who he is as far as you know, yeah?
People change, Velvet. Perhaps the Shepherd gave up hope. Maybe he lost faith in mankind. Fools prone to sin, endlessly generating malevolence.
He's not like that. If that's all true, then what point was there in Lofi's death?
Is there anything else in that book?
Yes and no. This copy itself is incomplete. There ought to be further pages, but they're missing. For now, I've done all I can.
There must be an original somewhere, right?
Without it, I doubt the Abbey would be plotting Ennomenot's revival. We can be sure they have complete understanding of their Empyrean's nature.
But this was the only copy in the Royal Villa. If the original is out there, who knows where it could be?
It's getting pretty late. why don't we call it a day?
Yeah, let's get some rest.
Hey, Lafayette! Medusa let me sleep in her bed last night. She's warm for a snake lady.
That's great.
She's gonna help me take a bath now. You should come join us, too.
What? I couldn't.
It's okay. I don't mind at all.
Hey, Kamoana, did you know? Dial started to grow a brand new tail.
Wow, really? I want to see?
He's up at the observation tower.
Let's go see! Medusa, you too!
All right. But don't run, or you'll trip.
Thanks, Eleanor. I appreciate it.
Having some girl trouble, my little Malik?
I'm just glad Kamoana and Medusa are starting to feel better.
Yeah, they both still have a long way to go, but it's such a relief to see them smiling.
We've got bigger things to worry about. Hurry up and locate the next Earth Pulse point.
Right, okay.
Must you always be so blunt, Velvet?
I must, in fact. We're up against the Abbey here, and sooner or later they'll find this place.
That's true, but still.
Do we go find another hideout?
No, we'll keep on the offensive. We'll capture the remaining Therians before the Abbey finds us.
As a swordsman, I can respect that mindset.
I'm not so sure we could hold this place anyway.
We've got no obligation to.
I found another Earth Pulse point. It's in the eastern part of East Gand, I think.
But that's... All right. We're headed for East Gand.
Then our first stop should be Port Taliesin.
I'm refraining from doing any cutscenes because that's gonna reduce my chances of getting copyrighted.
So you've kept your sense of taste?
In my dreams I have. Nowhere else.
Does that make this a dream?
It would have to be, wouldn't it? After all. I devoured you.
That's right. Don't you go forgetting it.
How could I ever forget it? The taste of your...
That was scary.
Looks like the fog's rolling in.
Yep.
Eleanor, there's something I want to be sure we get perfectly clear.
All right. What is it?
Lafayette is not your little Moloch.
What? That's all you wanted to say? You realize he doesn't belong to you either, right?
Indeed I do. Lafayette's his own person, and not anyone else's.
You're right. Malakim aren't just tools to be used by exorcists as they pleased.
I'll be more careful not to forget that. Good, as long as we're on the same page.
Since we're on the subject of reminders, you haven't forgotten our little bet, have you, Velvet?
You mean the 100 gold on whether I'd break? No, I haven't forgotten.
A word of caution. People can fight against pain, but they can't fight against happiness. If you're keen on winning our bet, I'd steer clear of ill-fitting dreams.
Sorry to break it to you, but all I have anymore are nightmares.
The fog's cleared. Good thing we didn't wind up getting lost in it.
Of course we didn't. Who do you think is running this ship?
A bunch of shameless rogues who are very good at shameless roguery.
Damn straight.
But it's strange. These waters don't usually see much fog.
There's a lot of cats on this island. Who the hell?
Whoa! It's like a castle!
This used to be the base of operations for a rich trading family. When trouble came knocking, they were ready for it, to say the least.
They must have had a lot of enemies.
But that was a long time ago. Nowadays, it's just another town in the middle of nowhere. But even so, to us, it was the big city of our dreams.
You know this area well.
I grew up near here. Keep on going, and you'll run into a ball. My home village.
Then, the Therian is...
Yeah, somewhere in my village.
Is that okay?
No one will know me there. Everyone I knew, I already devoured.
Yeah, she's a gangster. For some reason, I thought I beat this thing. That's a skunk with a beard. The hit list.
Damn! I forgot today was the day Nico was coming. I missed out on buying that special quiche.
That's too bad. I wish she'd just open up a shop here. You'd think it would be easier than always having to make the long trek from Abal.
I heard she doesn't want to leave the village because she's waiting for her missing friend to return.
What are you talking about? Abal's nothing but a ruin.
What? Well, you're a morbid young woman. Sure, the place was hit pretty bad by a demon a few years ago, but it's not like it's abandoned.
Many of the villagers were hurt, but thanks to Lord Artorias, nearly all of them survived in the end.
That can't be.
It certainly is. In fact, there's a girl from there, Nico, who comes here once a week to sell things.
Just yesterday, my husband sent medicine to the general store there and got some juicy prickleboar meat in return.
That can't be right. With my own hand,
Velvet?
Well, looks like she's gonna get a flashback from
the
past.
That's what I'd like to know.
That festival over in Abal sure was fun, wasn't it?
It sure was. What a cheerful and happy place. And the food was amazing.
I loved the prickleboar meatballs. Nico's quiche was so good. It was a master quiche.
This Nico must be a great cook. I'd love to try this master quiche.
Where did you learn a joke like that?
Anyway, Taliesin's Fisherman Festival is coming up soon. We've got to show the folks from Abal a good time.
Yeah, I'm gonna help my uncle catch lots of tasty fish for...
What do you think you'll catch?
Oh, God. Say a bunch of random...
Have to go there.
You guys know me, I got this thing about unnecessary dialogue. I do mean unnecessary.
And see for ourselves. Which way is your village?
It's far to the east, through the Morgana Woods.
I remember it is. Okay.
Nothing can stop these fists.
Instead, it's too late.
want to live, get out of my way.
One of our targets right there. Oh, really? Down at all. This again.
Say, do you know why Velvet was sent to that prison island in the first place?
It had to be to funnel the other prisoners' malevolence to...
There's an Earth Pulse point near a ball, right? Wouldn't it have been easier just to leave her there?
Lack of food, probably. I heard she devoured the entire village.
Could that rumor really be true?
Who can say?
You know it doesn't work like that.
All right, let's think. Why else would Artorias move Velvet to the island? If she was the first Therian he captured...
He needed a guinea pig to test out what was written in the ancient book!
Precisely. He made a special cage for her in the island prison, where Earth Pulse Point and Malevolence met. Then he used Velvet to test how Therians work.
Huh. I could see him doing that.
But turning his own family into an experiment.
I'm just offering a theory. But a man willing to sacrifice his brother's life... wouldn't likely show mercy to his sister either.
How could he be capable of such things?
Perhaps that's just how badly he wants to save this world. Or perhaps there's no other way it could be saved.
Huh?
There's a skunk.
Are we ready for this?
Take off all wind moves. Thank you. Maybe she was straight. So well, how the hell that happened? What the hell is my thing being killed so quick? That makes no sense. Look at that, why am I so... I didn't use bottles on this girl already. Of course.
Can't I hear?
Stop it, disgraceful.
I don't believe
it. Oh, really? Come on. I was way out the... Yeah, how come? every time I try to. Hold on a second, people. Hold on, something wrong. All right. There we go.
Thank you. It's a
fucking time. Bullshit for this game sometimes. I swear. Never knew a game where you could have no health and still don't make no sense.
Voice. What's going on?
Ocean Wing King. Thank you.
How can Nico be here?
I'm taking my word. Freaking water. He just bad to use here. He just main earth. Let's switch him out. Here we go again.
Wind light.
Alright, sorry about that. I had to run and check on something. Alright, but we good now.
I can't believe it. Is it really you? Velvet? What is this? How are you alive? I could ask you the same question. Where have you been this whole time? You just up and disappeared. Everyone thinks that you were eaten by a demon. But I knew it couldn't be true. You're too strong to let some crummy demon take you down. You're alive. Sorry, I didn't mean to embarrass you in front of your friends. I have to let everyone know the good news. You've finally come back to us!
Nico's alive. She's alive.
Don't let your guard down. I've got a bad feeling about this.
Well, naturally, we've got a Reaper with us.
Let's head for a ball. We can ask everyone there exactly what happened.
Yeah.
Yes.
Food's ready. It's nothing special. You sure you want me for this?
Velvet, I have to ask. Are you sure that the other village carpenters died that day?
Well, it's not like I have time to check.
I was getting some.
This can't be. After what I did, when he killed Luffy.
Velvet, are you all right?
Of course I'm all right. I know I'm right. I'm sure of it. This isn't how the village should be.
Well, let's stay calm and investigate.
I am calm. I'm fine. Really.
It didn't seem like that was someone else masquerading as this Nico girl.
But if she's the real thing, then something very unnatural is going on. You get me, Rokuro?
Yeah. We better keep an eye out.
How much longer is it going to take for us to get back to the village?
Thank you.
Velvet! You're really all right.
Oh, thank heavens! It's so good to see you!
Where have you been all this time? You never even wrote!
But I don't. I thought the whole village was wiped out that day.
Yeah, it nearly was.
But just when we thought it was all over, Arthur, Lord Artorias, saved us!
No, it was his doing in the first place! He sacrificed Lafayette!
It really was a shame what happened to that poor boy.
That's all you have to say? A shame? My brother Lafayette died
that- I'm sorry. Truly, I am. But you can't lose hope, dear.
He's right. What counts is that your brother's still alive.
He's alive?
He's in your house. Don't worry, we've all pitched in to take care of him.
I don't...
Velvet. Velvet, let's go to your house and see.
Yeah, okay.
Thank you.
That's right, we got new stuff we can buy. Thank you. about that. Took a time, I had to get up. Alright. There was a way I could pause this, but apparently not. Were we at 2 hours? How'd this dude... Somebody's attack was supposed to be close to like 400. I thought I got these already. I didn't. Where a lot of these waistcoats can go. Really, they're just taking up space. I forgot about this though. Thank you.
Luffy. Luffy's alive?
What's wrong?
Well, that didn't break it.
Next time you suspect an illusory art, test out your theory on yourself.
You think we're all seeing an illusion?
It's possible. It wouldn't be the first time.
But an entire village? That shouldn't be possible.
Shouldn't be, no.
How do we approach this? Try to break it apart at the seams somehow?
No. For now, we and our enemies share the same goal. Come on, help me look for the Therian.
Sure.
I think I'll stick with Velvet.
I won't stop you.
Keep a close eye on her. I don't think she's entirely right in the head at the moment.
Yeah.
My home. It hasn't changed a bit.
We need to be careful, Velvet. Aizen thinks this could be a trap.
You think Nico and everyone are being controlled?
I don't know. It's just...
You think it could be Melchior's doing. But even so... Not going to work on me.
You're insane.
People can fight against pain, but...
I won't be deceived by this.
You'll open your wound! He's been asleep. Ever since that day. I found him at the shrine. Collapsed on the ground. His wounds healed, but... he's never woken up.
If he's still alive, that's all that matters. I'll find a way to wake you again, Luffy. I still have to thank you for this comb, after all.
So, that's where Velvet's comb came from.
Did Lord Artorias really try to sacrifice such a defenseless child?
What's wrong, Lafayette? You don't look like your usual perky self.
I'm okay. I'm just glad Velvet's all right.
What? Your name is Lafayette too? What a weird coincidence!
Yeah.
Hey, sorry about all that, you guys.
Don't worry about it. What are we going to do now? If it were me, I'd make Lafayette something he really likes for dinner tonight. He can handle soup. Maybe he'll notice the smell of your cooking and it'll wake him up.
Yeah, maybe I should. Would you watch after him while I go buy what I need?
Of course. I am at your beck and call.
Is there anything I can do to help, too?
Yes, please. I'll need you to be my taste tester. All right. First, I'm going to whip up my special quiche. And then I'll throw in tomato and egg soup. And some pudding.
I didn't even know your face had smile muscles.
Hey, could I get some eggs, milk, spinach, and tomatoes? And I'd love to know what cheese you'd recommend, too.
You got it. And in celebration of your homecoming, I won't even charge. With you cooking up a feast like that, I'm sure Lafayette will wake up straight away.
Thanks. I really appreciate it.
You're getting spinach? I can't really handle it myself.
You'll never grow up strong if you don't eat your spinach, young lady.
I've done just fine without it so far, thank you.
Oh, if you insist, I'll leave it out just this once.
Wow, Velvet, you must be special. Not many folks get to be friends with an exorcist.
She's not my friend.
The way you two bicker, I find that hard to believe.
Oh, yeah. Do you have any prickle boar?
Oh, I'm sorry to say that I'm out at the moment.
That's fine. I'll hunt some up myself in the tranquil woods. Just like old times.
Actually, there haven't been any prickle boars there lately. You should try the Morgana Woods instead.
Okay, I'll do that. Thanks for the tip. Alrighty, to the Morgana Woods to hunt some prickle boars.
Yeah. Sure.
We're looking for prickle boars. Keep your eyes on the thickets.
We can do this!
A complete victory!
This is hunting?
We keep this up, and who knows how many we'll bring home. They were nothing.
We can do this! What's this?
Okay.
I just feel a little sorry for them is all.
I hear you. These prickle boars might have all been family. People can be so heartless. Yeah, I'd forgotten this feeling. But what can you do? At the end of the day, we have to eat just as much as they do.
Yes, what can you do in this situation indeed?
Luffy's waiting for us. We should run on home now.
Luffy.
shopping, hunting, laughing with friends. That was how her life used to be, wasn't it?
Yes. It reminds me of my own past.
Huh? But wasn't your village... I'm sorry.
It's not your fault. The happy times I shared with my family, I still treasure those memories. And even after the attack, I've still been able to find happiness. Eating a good meal, making new friends...
And falling in love?
Yes, falling in...
love?
Look what you made me say, Bianfu!
There's nothing to be ashamed of. Most every girl's happiest memories are of her first love, after all. Don't you think there was someone special out there Velvet had feelings for?
A first love? Do you really think so?
That's enough of that talk, Bianfu. You sound like an old man.
No! I'm only 150 years old and already being treated like an old man!
But still, I would like to meet the guy Velvet first fell for.
I wouldn't.
I see. You're a guy.
Heard the news about your brother. I'm happy for you.
So, what's your plan now?
You guys were snooping around the village.
Yeah, we wanted to check out that shrine too, but we got stopped. Apparently, the Abbey's designated it off-limits. If there's a Therian around, it's probably there.
I'm going to draw it out. If this is a trap, things may turn violent. Either way, this place is about to get a lot less tranquil.
The same as everywhere else I've been.
You can quit here if you like, but I'm going to keep on fighting the Abbey.
And if I try to stop you, you'll insist, I presume.
Velvet, no!
I'll give you one day. Once you've made up your mind, come meet me at the Cape.
I'm with him. How tomorrow shakes out depends on what you decide, Velvet.
Your hand. It's... As you can see, I'm a demon. 3 years ago, I was the one who attacked this village and...
I don't want to hear it! Demon, or no demon, you're still you! Okay, so you're scary! I'll get used to it. I promise, I'll keep it a secret. Let's just live here in the village like we used to, okay? You, me, and everyone else.
Nico.
That was rather good, Velvet.
Yeah. Lafayette gets a gold star for being such a good taste tester, too!
Tomorrow, I'll fix you up a nice stew.
Hey, is this... It's the original copy of the book on Enominot! And all the pages are here! Velvet!
Hey, Fee. Can I borrow your compass real quick? I'll give it right back. Please?
All right.
He really wanted a compass more than anything else. Just like you, he loved to stare out at the sea, wondering what's on the other side. He wanted to go adventuring someday.
Oh, I didn't know that.
I bet once he wakes up, you two will be really good friends.
So, this is what your life used to be like before everything happened, huh?
What's gotten into you? Maybe I made the pudding a little too sweet.
Velvet, how do you know what it tastes like?
I think I'll get myself some shut-eye.
But what are you going to do about tomorrow?
Mogulu, are there arts that let the caster manipulate dreams?
Huh? Dreams? Why?
There is, yes, an art that requires a certain type of Moloch. It envelops you in a fog and reads your regrets, then traps you in a happy dream.
An art that reads your regrets and shows you happiness. I'm going to the Cape.
Now? What on earth's gotten into you?
Velvet.
Velvet!
Don't go. Stay here. Stay with me.
This is Fee's compass. I'm sorry, Luffy.
No, don't. Wait. Velvet, wait. Don't. Don't leave me here.
Fog? Is this what Mogulu was talking about?
We're going to the Cape Shrine. It's time to drag out the Therian.
There you are.
Velvet, you have to stop your friends. They keep saying they're going to the Cape, and they just won't listen.
The Abbey's forbidden anyone from going inside. We'll all be punished if anyone breaks the rules.
I hate to say it, Nico, but I think I'm a terrible person. I really thought I could have my old life back again, and I could forget everything else. I tried to act like I was doing it for Luffy, but it was all for myself. But I can't forget. I shouldn't forget. Luffy is dead. He was murdered without even knowing why. I will never forgive that. Ever! So get out of my way. If you don't, I'll devour you again!
Velvet. Why?
Why must you do that?
There we go. The truth at last.
Mind telling me what the hell's going on?
It's a trap. Trap, trap, trap. Our enemy spun an illusion based on Velvet's dreams.
That's a nasty little art.
But Velvet saw through it all?
She did. But even if it's all a dream, such brutality on her part.
Velvet's always been our brutal poodle. But to shake off the dream by herself, now that's something. The boundary between dreams and reality is demarcated solely by one's own heart.
What?
I'm saying she's wowie zowie cool beans. Come on, we gotta hurry.
It was all a dream. Hell, even if it wasn't,
I won't turn back! She's a part of my fire here!
Wait.
Yeah. know you.
Nico's dog.
I'll finish this.
Now, rise, arise, ascending angel! Look what I found! Go get him, you little bulldog! No mercy!
Wounds I won't see!
Sorry, pups. You're coming with me.
Velvet!
It's okay. I killed their owner. I deserve all their hate. And then some. But not now. Understand? Once I get my revenge, you can tear me apart if you like. I promise. Until then, I'll need your help.
Guess the art finally evaporated.
The book! It disappeared!
What book?
I I found a copy of the ancient book with every page still intact. It was in Velvet's house.
Artorias's book! The real one might still be there. We should go back to Velvet's house to search for it.
Put nothing on our hit list. I don't have anything for D. Thank you. What the hell was that? I didn't take her stuff out, don't wonder.
Yes.
This is fire. Ooh, I love that so bad. Wonder what's something going on. I completely read that wrong. What type of BS was that? Thank you. That make no sense.
Are we ready for this?
Mines are always.
Thank you. Okay,
The video right there.
There's nobody here.
This is reality.
Empty.
No surprise there. Artorias is too thorough to overlook something like that.
If only I'd showed it to you as soon as I found it.
Don't beat yourself up over it. We wouldn't have been able to read it without Grimoire anyhow. It was just a dream. All of it. Those are the graves of my sister and her son. He died before he was even born.
They're in rough shape. We should lay some flowers.
Don't bother. There's no point.
A keen insight. Eating one would be cruel enough, but plucking an innocent flower just to offer it as decoration for some memorial. That's not even a sacrifice, just a cruelty devoid of all purpose.
Melchior!
As obtuse as ever.
I take it you're the one behind the dream fog?
I must say, you did well to break through such resolve. If you weren't a Therian, I'd be tempted to take you under my wing.
Did you come here to flatter me?
Indeed. Although I was already in the neighborhood to retrieve this book.
I'll be taking that.
This book was compiled by my dear friend, who was also Artorias's mentor and predecessor as head of the exorcists. It contains the hopes and dreams left by a noble soul who gave his life for the world that grieved him. It is not for a tainted demon to touch.
Like we need your permission!
Look who obeyed me for once.
Is that... You didn't!
Be patient. You'll know everything before long. What we seek is the realization of a perfect order, as tranquil and beautiful as a wildflower in bloom.
A perfect order?
Let's go. There's nothing left for us here.
Well, this is gonna be the end of this stream. No sooner than I save it.
Actually, it's a copy that Lafayette made.
Lafayette made a copy of the book. He transcribed it all by hand, and then he sold it just to buy me that comb.
There was something here for us after all.
Lafayette.
If that's the complete manuscript, we might be able to unravel Enominat's secrets.
We'll have to show it to Grimoire.
Pulling one over on the old man, are you? Never a dull moment with Lady Calamity around.
Alright. That's gonna be it for tonight, man. I thought I was gonna be able to finish it, but looks like I'm